Winkle, and today we're building a zoo! Ella, we love going to the zoo, right?
Yes.
What's your favorite animal?
Probably the zebras.
The zebras?
Yes.
I've always liked the monkeys.
Yes, yeah. I love the monkeys.
They're so fun to watch, like hanging from the trees, and I happen to have a monkey at my house named Ella. You've always been my monkey, huh? Always hanging on stuff. Well, should we see what's in our kit today, monkey?
Yeah.
Okay.
2 pieces of graph paper, 1 piece of white paper, 2 straws, 2 pipe cleaner, 2 popsicle sticks, 5 animals, 2 pool noodle pieces, a cup, Winkle sticker, and a wooden cube.
Wow, that's a lot of stuff in our kit today.
I know.
This is gonna be an awesome zoo. Okay, on top of everything in your kit, you will need your box today, your Winkle box. If you don't have your Winkle box, you could use any box or piece of cardboard or even a poster board, because we're going to be laying it flat and making the zoo out of that. Also for your project today, you'll need a marker or a pen, scissors, and glue or a glue stick.
Sounds great.
Yeah? You ready to get started?
Yeah.
Let's do it. This is gonna be so fun. Usually, Ella and I do our own projects, but since the zoo is so big, we're going to be doing it together today.
Are we going to be making cages for the animals?
We've given you a lot of stuff to decorate your zoo today and make it really fun, but if you have anything else at home, totally go and do that. That sounds amazing. Okay, so you're gonna take your box and you can pull up on the edges to flatten it out. Like that. And then any flaps like this, if you bend it back the other way, then they'll lay pretty flat.
This is gonna be a humongous zoo.
Oh, it's gonna be so amazing. Today when we're building our zoo, we're gonna be learning about area and perimeter. Do you know what that means?
No.
No, they're great math concepts to learn, especially if you're ever going to be designing a floor plan, like of a house or of your room. Or if you're trying to measure for carpet or anything like that, you're always gonna need to know area and perimeter. So each animal at the zoo is going to have their own habitat, and that habitat has to be measured by area and perimeter. So we have our wooden cube right here.
Mm-hmm.
This we're going to turn into a dice. Do you remember dice?
Yes.
Yeah, so we're gonna kind of play a game to come up with our area and perimeter for our animals.
Ooh.
On our cube, we're gonna start with the number 3. Okay?
Okay,
then we're gonna count up from there. 3,
4,
that's right,
5,
6, now the other side, 7, and last one is 8. This is going to be a fun game to help us decide our area and perimeter of each animal habitat. The reasons we don't wanna use 1 and 2 is because they'll be too small and our animal will be all cramped up in there.
Yeah.
Okay, Ella, so everybody's animals at home are going to be a little bit different, but pick which animal you want to make a habitat for first.
I want to do the kangaroo.
The kangaroo? Okay. Okay, so everything we roll is going to be for the kangaroo. Go ahead and roll our first measurement for the kangaroo habitat.
4.
Okay, so this is what we do. We go across 1, 2, 3, 4 lines and put a line right there. That means our habitat is gonna be 4 across, and now we decide how many squares down it's gonna be. Go ahead.
3.
3 squares down. Oh, small habitat for a kangaroo. 1, 2, 3. So that is the perimeter of our kangaroo habitat. It's 4 by 3. See that?
Mm-hmm. So is this gonna be the habitat for the kangaroo?
Yes, this green rectangle that we're making will represent the kangaroo habitat. And you can put a little border on it, and we can even decorate this more later. So the perimeter, if you're gonna say, what is the perimeter of the kangaroo habitat? You're going to add all these squares across. So how many is that across? 4.
4.
4 across. How many down?
1, 2, 3.
4 plus 3. And then how many across this way?
1, 2, 3, 4.
4 plus 4 plus 1, 2, 3 equals 4 plus 3 is 7 plus 4 plus 3 is 7. So 7 plus 7?
14.
14. So if someone said, what's the perimeter of your kangaroo habitat?
14.
14. Now the area is different. The area is adding up all this space in here. So we get that by multiplying 4 by 3. So 4 right here times 3, oops, times 3. Do you know what 4 times 3 is?
4 times 3 is 12.
Good, 4 times 3 is 12. And the way I remember my times 3 multiplication facts is I sing a song. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30, 33. Good, so we have our kangaroo habitat right there. Do you wanna go ahead and cut that out?
Yes.
Okay. While Ella's cutting that out, I am going to make a sign because whenever you're at the zoo, you always follow the signs so that you can find your favorite animals. Good. And then we have the sign that says kangaroo. We're gonna cut that out. Good. Then we're just gonna take our kangaroo sign, our kangaroo habitat, and our kangaroo, and we're just gonna set it aside for right now. The thing I love about this activity is everyone's is going to be different because everyone got different animals. You'll all be rolling different size habitats and you're all gonna decorate it differently. So it's gonna be so fun to see everybody's zoo and what they made, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Ella, what animal do you wanna pick from next time?
The zebra.
The zebra. Okay, what did we roll for the zebra?
5. 5.
So can you measure?
Is that 5 across?
Yes, 5 across. So you can measure 5 across?
That's good for a zebra.
That is good for a zebra because he might like to run around.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay, mark it right there. 5. Nope, that's 4. There we go. 5. Okay, roll again.
6.
Okay, count down 6. Wow, that is gonna be a really nice size habitat for our zebra. Go ahead and cut out the habitat for your second animal. And then we're gonna write zebra. So Ella, can we figure out the area and perimeter of this zebra habitat? The perimeter is adding up all the sides. So let's add up all the sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 plus?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6 plus?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Plus? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. 5 plus 6 is what?
5 plus 6 is 11.
Okay, plus another 5 plus 6, which is 11. So 11 plus 11.
11 plus 11 is 22?
Yeah.
Okay.
So our perimeter is 22, and let's find the area. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Times 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6.
5 times 6. Let's count by 5s to 6. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Nice. So our area, that means all this space, is 30.
Ooh.
Okay. And then we're going to set that one aside. We're gonna go ahead and make the habitats for our last three animals. So go ahead and pause the video, and when you're all caught up with your habitats, you can press play to continue. If you have any questions on how to make the habitats, you can always rewind the video and press play again. Okay, we have all our animals and their habitats. This is so awesome. Now you guys at home can totally color your habitat. You can put like grass or water or anything you want inside, or just color it a color, or you can leave it plain. For this part, you'll want some colored pencils, markers, or crayons. While Ella's coloring those, I'm gonna make a Winkle Zoo sign. I gave you guys a Winkle sticker, and this sticker is pretty awesome. You could actually put it on your water bottle if you want, because it is a vinyl sticker. Today, I'm gonna use it to make a sign for the zoo. The Winkle
Zoo.
Oh, Ella, looks so pretty. Which habitat is that for?
The giraffe.
Oh, nice. Ella has finished coloring the giraffe habitat. See how she made a little watering hole for the giraffe and some grass? So I'm gonna show you how to start putting your zoo together. Okay, so decide where the entrance is for your zoo. Mine is gonna be right here, and that's where I'm gonna put the Winkle Zoo sign, right there. So that's gonna be my entrance. Now you have to kind of plan out where all your animals are going to be in the zoo. You wanna make sure that you have room for everybody. See how I've laid everything out to make sure I have room for all of my animals? That is gonna look really nice. Plus, you want a little room for people to be able to walk around, maybe sit somewhere, or even get a snack. What's your favorite snack when you're at the zoo, Ella?
Cotton candy.
I didn't even have to ask that. I already knew you were gonna say cotton candy. Mine is probably popcorn. That just reminds me of the zoo. Okay, so I'm going to glue down the giraffe habitat right here. One thing I love about the Phoenix Zoo is looking at all the different plants and trees that are there. So we are going to put a tree at our zoo. In fact, we have enough supplies to make two trees. And do you know what we're gonna make that out of?
What?
A popsicle stick and a pool noodle.
Ooh.
All you have to do is take your scissors and make a little slice into the pool noodle with one of the blades. Then you're going to stick your popsicle stick in there, and you have a little tree. Kind of looks like a lollipop. Then you can take your scissors or a pencil to poke a hole in your box somewhere and insert your popsicle stick through that hole. That is so cool. Ella made a little giraffe feeder out of pipe cleaner and straw. So she stuck, would you use a push pin?
Yes.
Okay, so she went and grabbed a push pin and pushed the pipe cleaner, made holes in the straw, and then pushed the pipe cleaner through those holes. And then she put holes in her giraffe habitat, and then she can stick that feeder in there. Very nice, Ella. To make a sign stand up in our zoo, we're gonna cut a piece of straw about 1.5 inches or 2 inches. And we're going to take a piece of our graph paper and a piece of our sign, like this, and we're going to sandwich them together. So put some glue on the graph paper, put the straw in between, and press the sign down. Then I just poked a hole right here with my pencil, and I'm gonna stick the straw through the hole. So there's our giraffe habitat, all done. Ella, I love how creative you're being with the straw and pipe cleaner and popsicle sticks and everything that we provided for you. There's one last thing we haven't talked about, and that is this paper cup. What do you think we can make out of this?
What about a bench?
Yeah, you can make a bench. Anything else?
I don't know.
Okay, well, I have an idea. Do you want to know my idea?
Yeah.
I love when a zoo has a water feature, like either a splash pad or a water fountain or something like that. And so I thought we could make a fountain out of this paper cup. All right, so to make a fountain, you're gonna make several cuts into the middle of the cup. The cuts should be about 1/2 inch apart and going straight down to the middle of the cup. Now you're going to curl each one with your marker or your pencil to make it come out like this and look like it's a fountain. What do you think?
I like it.
Should we color it?
Yeah.
I think so.
Let's color it blue.
Good idea. Okay, so I'm getting ready to make the cheetah habitat. Again, I'm going to cut a little piece of paper from the graph paper, and I cut a little piece of straw. Put the straw in the middle, make a little sandwich, put the cheetah sign on top of the straw. Then I'm going to poke a hole in my box. Okay, and then my cheetah has a little sign right there. Okay, and then I love all the plants, like I said, at the zoo, so I'm going to make, I made little grasses right here out of my straw pieces, but also I was thinking like a flower, you know? This pipe cleaner I could turn into a pretty flower.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The water fountain is done.
Let's see it. Woo, she colored it all blue on the inside and then curled all these over to make it look like it's spraying out.
Yeah, like
that's great. Okay, I'm gonna glue the water fountain down right here.
Ooh, so pretty.
Oh, I would love to go to this zoo.
Yeah.
This is a great zoo. Oh, cute, Ella, you made a bench.
Uh-huh.
That's great, because when I go to the zoo, I love to be able to sit down.
Yeah.
Maybe under the shade of one of our trees. Yes, great idea. Sit down and I watch you guys play and run around while I'm sitting in the shade. Wow, we are done with our zoo. It looks so good.
It looks amazing.
Yeah.
Winkle Zoo.
Welcome to the Winkle Zoo. Da-da-da-da.
Add a shrink and go inside of there.
Oh my goodness, that's such a good idea. And kids at home can keep creating and building on this zoo. You can even play with it with your Legos or whatever other toys you have at home, right?
I should go get a Polly Pocket.
This has been such a fun project. Thanks for joining me today. You are so creative and fun, Ella.
You're welcome.
I can't wait to see what everybody out there made. If you have a grown-up take a picture or video of you making your zoo, they can put it on social media, Instagram or Facebook, and tag us at the Winkle Crate. That way we can see what you made and how it turned out. I can't wait to see it. Everybody's is gonna be so different and so unique and so special. Ella, I think we should go to the zoo.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is really inspiring me. Let's get going. Bye.
Bye-bye.
We're gonna do the Hey everybody, don't forget to like and subscribe to The Winkle so every time we come out with new STEM videos, you'll be the first to know. Also, check out our freebies and our website down below for more STEM ideas.
I'm sorry, I need to...